Ever since the beacon of innovations during the Industrial Revolution, we have aimed to achieve greater mega projects that factors in our growing population and its energy usage. Around 30 years ago, a group of industrial nations decided to take on a project and develop a new, cleaner, and more sustainable source of energy. This is how ITER, or the International Thermonuclear Experimental Reactor, the world's largest nuclear fusion project, came into existence. So let's take a look at what it is and why it is the most significant mega project in the history of our entire civilization. In southern France, about 35 nations have collaborated in building the world's largest tokamak device. This machine is a magnetic fusion device that is designed to prove the feasibility of fusion on a larger scale and carbon-free source of energy based on the principle that powers our stars and sun. So what this means is that we will be able to create the same amount of energy as it is being emitted from our sun. But how will that be even possible? To answer this, we must first look at the process of fusion and how the tokamak reactor will yield and sustain such energy output. Essentially, fusion is the energy source of the sun and stars. Within the core of these stellar bodies, tremendous heat and gravity fuse lighter elements such as hydrogen into heavier elements such as helium, which releases enormous amount of energy in the process. There are three main criteria that must be fulfilled in order to achieve fusion in a laboratory. First, a very high temperature reaching about 150 million degrees Celsius. Second, a sufficient plasma particle density in order for collision to occur. And lastly, sufficient confinement time to hold the plasma, which has a tendency to expand with the defined volume. Through this process, electrons are separated from nuclei, which turns gas into plasma. This is often referred to as the fourth state of matter. These fusion plasmas provide the environment in which light elements can fuse and yield energy. So tokamak is the device that takes the main criteria into account and is able to produce powerful magnetic fields that are used to confine and control the plasma. The term tokamak comes from a Russian acronym that stands for toroidal chamber with magnetic coils. It was first developed by the Soviet researchers in the late 1960s. Ever since then, the tokamak has been adopted around the world as the most promising configuration of magnetic fusion device. ITER will be the world's largest tokamak to date, with it being twice the size of the largest machine currently in operation, with 10 times the plasma chamber volume. Inside this experimental machine, the energy produced through the fusion of atoms is absorbed as heat in the walls of the vessels. This heat then produces steam and then electricity through turbines and generators, similar to our conventional power plants today. Physicists use the tokamak's donut-shaped vacuum chamber to shape and control the plasma by the massive coils placed around the vessel, which confines the hot plasma away from the vessel walls. The components of the reactor include a 100 feet diameter cryostat device intended to surround the reactor in order to keep its vital components from overheating. Furthermore, central solenoid magnets are responsible for inducing and stabilizing the superheated plasma. The tokamak will draw 50 megawatts of electricity to ignite the fusion process in producing stable plasma. This plasma would then put out some 500 megawatts of power in short intervals, thereby generating a whopping 10 times energy return. So, what is this mega project going to accomplish for us? Well, the core goal of ITER is to produce a tenfold return on energy. It will also demonstrate the integrated operation of technologies for fusion power plant, as well as achieve deuterium tritium plasma, in which the reaction is sustained through internal heating. This will offer scientists a unique opportunity to chart new territory in controlled nuclear fusion. One of the missions of the late stages of ITER operation is to demonstrate the feasibility of producing tritium within the vacuum vessel. If successful, tritium will be used to cover the needs of future power plants. The construction of the ITER has been underway since 2010. The first phase includes the assembly of the core machine as well as the installation of all plant systems needed for the first plasma generation in December 2025. This phase will be followed by operation in deuterium with a small amount of tritium to test wall shielding provisions by 2035. Finally, scientists will launch a third phase with increasingly frequent operation with an equal mixture of deuterium and tritium at full fusion power. The ITER project has inspired many smaller enterprises to develop their versions of fusion generation technology. These include UK-based Tokamak Energy, California-based Tri-Alpha Energy by Microsoft and Google. Moreover, Canada's General Fusion uses a vortex of molten lead and lithium for its plasma containment design, which has attracted the support of Amazon. America's Lockheed Martin is in the midst of developing a secretive compact fusion reactor no bigger than a truck that it claims will be ready for testing by 2028. But it all started with ITER, leading the fusion generation technology. The ITER project's large-scale international cooperation is an example of how scientific research knows no geographic borders. This model was and should be adopted in other areas of science for us to advance further as a civilization. If you enjoyed this video, do leave a like, share, and subscribe to our channel for more content like this. When do you think we will be able to master the fusion technology? Let us know your thoughts in the comments down below. Until then, we'll see you in the next one.